Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. I'm here to review the fourth and final installment in the House of Night Otherworld series by PC and Kristen Cast, namely Found. If you guys haven't heard of the House of Night Otherworld series, the House of Night Otherworld series is kind of like a continuation of the House of Night series by PC and Kristen Cast. You can read both of these series independently of one another, although if you read the House of Night Otherworld series, you're obviously going to get spoiled for things that happened in the House of Night series. Essentially, the House of Night Otherworld series follows the main characters from the House of Night series about a year after the final book in the House of Night series. And if you guys haven't yet heard or read the House of Night, original House of Night series, the House of Night series is basically about a girl named Zoe Redbird who gets marked by a vampire tracker and is then in transitioning to being a full-fledged vampire. And basically in this world, which is set in Tulsa, Oklahoma in America, vampires basically go through a four-year transition from being a human into a vampire, during which they are called fledglings. It is very, very possible that you can die from and not make the transitioning into a full-fledged vampire. And also, the fledglings attend a school called the House of Night. There are multiple House of Nights everywhere around the world, since there are vampires everywhere around the world, because they need to be in the direct vicinity of adult vampires so that they don't die. And this basically follows Zoe Redbird as she moves into this House of Night, as she makes new friends. In this book, basically also, these vampires worship a goddess called Nyx, and there is also a lot of elemental magic involved. So yeah, if you haven't read the House of Night series, I would personally very much recommend them, because I very much enjoy and is still and have enjoyed the House of Night series. The first book is Marked, and it continues all the way to the 12th book, Redeemed. But again, if you guys don't want to read the whole House of Night series, you guys can also start by just reading the House of Night Otherworld series. The first book is called Loved, and there are a total of 4 books in the House of Night Otherworld series. But as I said, if you read the House of Night Otherworld series without first reading the original House of Night series, you will definitely get spoiled for things that happened in the House of Night original series. So I wouldn't recommend you start reading this if you were still planning to, or if you feel like reading the other series first. Please don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed this content. And also, if you haven't yet already, please subscribe to my channel. But without further ado, let's jump into the review. Overall, as you guys can probably see from my face expression, I absolutely loved Found so very much. I think, and I'm not joking when I say this, that when I finished Found, I literally just sat there in my chair, like quietly for a couple minutes, and I thought to myself, like, what a great finale this book was to the House of Night Otherworld series, and also just like the House of Night series, like in general. This story perfectly concluded every character's journey. Every character had some kind of closure, and every relationship had some kind of closure. I also feel like the book perfectly hit that like sweet spot between being like slightly bittersweet but also really happy in the end. Overall, I really loved seeing the characters from the Otherworld series and also the House of Night original series get together. I loved this book. I gave it 5 out of 5 stars. I think the ending was perfect. Basically, it was all I could have hoped for and more. Every character had a perfectly rounded off ending. I think that every conversation that took place between the characters was very meaningful and important. And yeah, that's pretty much all I can say without spoiling you guys about this book. If you guys have read the Otherworld series, you will know that the story also very heavily follows the other Neferet. And without going into any detail, I will say that probably her story was by far the most interesting, complex, crazy story. And I just love the way that PC and Kristen Cast wrote, yeah, like her story and her arc. And I can't really say very much without spoiling you guys. So yes, if you guys haven't yet read Found, I would highly recommend that you guys go and pick it up. If you've read the Otherworld series, if you haven't read the Otherworld series, I would recommend that you guys either go read the House of Night series or the House of Night Otherworld series. This is a world that is very close to my heart. I have connected with these characters so much over the years. I first read marked when I was 14, and I essentially survived the transitioning into moving to Germany from Holland at the time by reading this book series. And so the characters are very familiar to me, and I also feel like PC and Chris and Cass do a great job at capturing the original character's essence in this Otherworld series that was essentially, yeah, brought out 10 years after the original first marked book, which I think is awesome. I am now going to get into the spoilers of Found. So if you haven't read this book yet, then don't watch the next section, but yeah, keep watching if you've read the book or if you don't mind getting spoiled. The first thing that I want to talk about is Other Nefert's story in Found. And I think that probably most of you guys are going to agree, if you've read this book, that this is definitely, like, she is definitely like the most complex and interesting character probably from the entire House of Night series. And seeing her like redemption and her like going from, yeah, this woman who's just like absolutely obsessed with like gaining immortality to like sort of like opening herself up more and more to feeling love again, until eventually like the love of Nyx just like floods back into her heart and she is then able to accept light and love again, was just incredibly beautiful and poetic. You can very strongly see the differences between Other Nefert and Nefert, especially in this book. I think that in the previous books, or for example in Forgotten, I think that these differences were not as strong as they were in this book, but in this book it is basically shown just how different the two of them are. Other Nefert has a lot more capacity for love and care and empathy. She herself has, yeah, bonded with Other Linnet, her handmaiden, and yeah, they have a beautiful friendship almost, like, even amidst all this sort of like gross and evil stuff that they do, or, you know, that Nefert has done, I definitely feel like their friendship was very beautiful. And I was so shocked when Other Nefert basically allowed Other Linnet to like drink from her and imprint with her. I think that that was definitely something that was probably the thing that I was most surprised about, in my opinion, except for like the ending as well. Like, the Nefert from the original House of Night series would definitely not have allowed that. And you can definitely tell, yeah, that like she cares a lot more for Linnet than the Other Nefert cared about her. You can also tell that she doesn't really enjoy like the suffering and the pain that she inflicts on others, especially in comparison to Nefert, who like actually revels in the torture and punishment and like evil that she's doled out. Whereas Nefert, or Other Nefert herself, says that, you know, those five girls that they eventually like kill, who were like really mean and like racist and disgusting, like, even those people, she said like she was glad that they didn't suffer very much, like, and she was sad that she had to kill them. So it seems like, although her actions are very definitely characterized by darkness as well, she at least feels like she has to commit these acts out of a necessity rather than for the sheer pleasure of it. You can tell that she's definitely, yeah, a lot more human. She feels a lot deeper than Nefert does. And this is made especially clear when she actually breaks Nefert out of her tomb and realizes that this disgusting, horrible, perverse creature that Nefert has become is not the path that she wants for herself. She realizes that what darkness could really do to her. And I think that is really the turning point for her in this book. Nefert herself says this on page 245 when she discusses what she saw with Linnet. She says, "Witnessing what that creature has become shook me to my core and made me realize that I cannot allow myself to be such a whore to power that I sell my soul to achieve it. I have power, I have wealth, and with you, I now have family. I believe that might be enough for me to find not immortality, not dominance overall, but perhaps contentment in this lifetime, which is something I have not known since I was an unmarked girl in Chicago, dreaming of the kindness of a husband and a family of my own." And I think that that is just beautiful. She and Linnet then started to talk about like their plans for the future, and I was just like, she's gonna die, isn't she? Like, this is not gonna happen. Like, she's gonna sacrifice herself for Linnet. There's no way that she's gonna survive this book. And I was so pleasantly surprised, and I was so happy that by the end of the book, there's like this showdown that goes down between Other Nefert and Nefert. There's that beautiful scene where she stabs Nefert with this like double-sided spear, which is also visible on the cover. I don't know if you guys noticed this or not. And then Nefert basically pulls her towards her, and she also gets stabbed and she is basically dying. And then Aphrodite rushes in, and with her like newly given powers, she is then also able to give other Nephrit a second chance at life. And I was just like in tears as I was reading this. I was like, this cannot be happening. Like, I thought she was gonna die. This is beautiful, this is poetic, like that this whole story of like other Nephrit and Nephrit like makes a full circle. And I first of all, I was not expecting her to survive the fight. And then second of all, I most definitely was not expecting her to be turned back into like a 16-year-old Emily. And I think that that was just absolutely beautiful. Like the way that her tendrils of darkness turned back into Skylar, her cat, and everything just makes it full circle. The darkness is healed, you know, like she then has the capacity to now choose light and love. Yeah, so I found that absolutely beautiful. The next thing that I was really heartbroken by and sad was obviously seeing other Aphrodite again in Nyx's realm as a spirit. I think like that was probably the thing that was most heartbreaking in my opinion. I was very happy that Kevin got to see her again, that they got to interact. In fact, when Skyach told other Kevin that they were gonna travel through Nyx's realm through the help of Aphrodite's spirit, I was like, yes, we're gonna see Aphrodite again, and I was so happy. And then he did actually see her, and I was really happy to see her again. I was not over her death in Forgotten. I still think that was really, really sad. And yeah, seeing them interact, I think on the one hand, it was really sad the way that she was telling him, like, you have to find love again. Like, you can, you know, you have to move on. I only feel love now for you. No jealousy, no hatred. But also, I also think that this conversation or these conversations that they had with one another were very important to give the relationship and other Kevin's story a sense of closure. And I thought that the conversations that they had were very beautiful, though again very bittersweet. And speaking of conversations, the same thing basically happens between other Stark and Zoe, and also Zoe and other Heath. I think that basically PC cast added in a lot of these conversations between characters where like their relationship was the focal point, and I just found that to be very beautiful. I feel like, as I said before, it gave the characters a lot of closure. I also think it was very nice how both other Kevin and also other Stark were able to realize that Zoe and Aphrodite were not the people that they had actually fallen in love with. Like, even though they were sort of like mirror images of each other, they were still different people. And although they were kind of like made of the same essence, these were not the actual people that they fell in love with. I really, really love how PC and Chris and Cass, and also like the series, very beautifully emphasized just how important like our free will and our choices are in like shaping us to be who we are and who we love. And I think this is very reflected in these conversations that I just talked about between other Kevin and Aphrodite, and between other Stark and Zoe. Even though these people are the mirror images of one another and they are very similar, like they're still different people. And I think this really shows that, yeah, like who we are, the choices that we make, and our environment, our surroundings, the people that we immerse ourselves with, and also our families, they all influence us to such a great extent that, yeah, like there isn't just like this one person out there who is like destined to be our soulmate, and like it's like ride or die, you know, but that we have probably multiple people in our world that we could fall in love with, that we could make a connection to, that could like become our soulmate, if you will. But that our choices and our free will, like they do shape us to be different people. And then depending on our choices, we find ourselves with one person, or if we made other choices with a different person. And I think this is very beautifully highlighted in the House of Night Otherworld series, as well as the original House of Night series, that like just how important our free will and our choices are in shaping who we are. And I honestly found that message to be very beautiful, as well as empowering. Now I want to talk about the ending, which was definitely the part of the book that, along with Nephrit allowing Lynette to imprint on her, definitely had me most shocked. But yeah, also was really beautiful and had me in tears. And I'm specifically talking about the part where Aphrodite, yeah, comes and gives other Nephrit a second chance at life, and also where Nyx appears and then gives everyone like different gifts and like blessings, if you will. I was really happy that Rephaim had his Raven curse lifted off of him and that he can now be with Stevie Ray 24/7. That was beautiful. I was always wondering, like, while reading the other world series, whether that was something that PC and Chris and Cass were gonna include in the series, because obviously Rephaim has become a completely different person. And even though I understand why Nyx kind of like didn't punish him, but he had like a penance to pay, I was always hoping that eventually that curse, or not curse, but like that thing would have been lifted off of him. And I was really happy to find that it was in this book. I was also really, really shocked. Probably the thing that, in my opinion, was the most beautiful part of this book, alongside other Nephrit actually turning back into Emily, was when Lynette was granted vampirism by Nyx in the final pages of this book, right after Emily, yeah, was turned back. And I was just like sobbing. I love them together so much. Like, Lynette and Nephrit just have such a beautiful friendship, and you can definitely tell that they care for each other very much. They're inseparable, and I just found it really beautiful how Nyx then gave her a adult vampire mark so that she could then be with Nephrit, during the time that she then was gonna grow up and stuff. And yeah, although I don't quite still 100% understand, like, know or understand whether their love is really truly just platonic, or whether there is sort of like the sexual element to it, and that maybe in the future they might be lovers, I just love their friendship, I love their love, and I'm really happy that they get to be together now forever. And then I want to talk about the very, very final thing that we find out in this book, which is that Emily, aka Nephrit, has been granted an affinity over old magic by Nyx. First of all, I was quite surprised that she did that, but in a way it kind of makes sense. I think that this is just, as PC Cast has said multiple times in interviews, this really does leave a door wide open for, future books, future installments. And I would love to see Emily growing into these, like, new powers and growing up and stuff. If PC Cast, like, ever wanted to write, like, a novella or, like, a new series that just focused on Emily, I would be so down for that. I also think that her having old magic is also in a way very interesting, because you can tell that this power that she's gonna have is gonna have a lot to do with also whether now, given a second chance, she's really gonna choose light over darkness, or whether she's gonna go, you know, and choose darkness again. And I think because it's such like an unpredictable and neutral element, I kind of feel like it represents this choice that she's been given, if that makes sense. But yeah, I would be really interested in knowing what happens. I was very, very surprised by that. But I thought it was really great. I also think it's really sweet that they sort of like agreed that they were gonna like still visit each other and stuff, and that like that wasn't like not allowed. So yeah, I would love to see future books, especially featuring Emily and Lynette together, but also the Nerd Herd. This is definitely a series that I can just keep coming back to. I will never be sick of new books coming out. The same goes for the Shadowhunter Chronicles, which are like down there. Yeah, thank you PC and Chris and Cass so much for crafting this beautiful, beautiful world, these characters that I fall in love with, and these stories that really resonate with people. I think this world is just beautiful and magical, and please keep writing the books. I will keep reading them. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like, and also leave a comment down below if you have anything to add or anything to say. And also, please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and if you're new here. I hope that you guys are having a great day, morning, evening, wherever you are, and I will see you guys soon. Bye!